From Chihuahuas to Great Danes, dogs come in all shapes and sizes. Among hundreds of dog breeds, each one is finely tuned for a specific role, and the secret behind this lies in their DNA. This is my dog, Louis, a border collie, and this breed is well known for being herding dogs. In this video, with Louis' help, we will dive into the genetics behind selective breeding and how this has resulted in sport success of sport hunting dogs. Welcome to the genetic basis of stuff and things. You may now be wondering, what are sport hunting dogs? The American Kennel Club categorizes breeds into 7 groups based on their specific functions. Sport hunting dogs, or the sporting group, include retrievers, spaniels, pointers, and setters. They were bred to assist hunters by pointing and retrieving quarry over great distances. In contrast, for dogs that belong to the herding group like Louis, they generally possess an instinctual ability to control the movement of other animals. The next question to ask would be, how does genetics influence different dogs' ability in performing their tasks? In 2018, Kim and his colleagues studied the genetic basis of athletic success in sport hunting dogs. They were the very first to explore the genetics of physiological traits associated with breed-specific functions, in this case, sport hunting. By sequencing the genomes of 21 sport hunting dogs and comparing the single nucleotide variants with dogs from other groups, the researchers identified 59 genes under strong selection in sport hunting dogs. Most of these genes influence cardiovascular, neuronal, or muscular functions. One gene under strong selection was A6-3, or acid-sensing ion channel 3. This gene is expressed in peripheral sensory neurons, and the protein it encodes forms acid-sensing ion channels, or ASICs, in the cell membrane. These channels are activated by extracellular protons that accumulate in muscles during exercise. Activation of these channels causes cation influx, leading to depolarization and action potential firing in nociceptors. This process can result in hyperalgesia, a condition with increased sensitivity to pain. Notably, research has shown that A6-3 knockout mice experienced no hyperalgesia after experimentally induced muscle fatigue, highlighting that A6-3 gene expression is essential for post-exercise muscle pain. In Kim's study, a single nucleotide variant was identified in these A6-3 gene of many sport hunting dogs, producing a derived T allele compared to the ancestral C allele found in wolves. This single nucleotide variant caused a non-synonymous mutation at the 512th amino acid residual, where leucine is encoded instead of proline. The T allele was found to be highly frequent only in the haplotypes of sport hunting dogs, suggesting that there was a strong selection pressure for the T allele within sport hunting breeds. Although we don't yet know exactly how this mutation in A6-3 gene could impact the gene products, researchers hypothesized that the T allele is selected because it may have a loss of function role, thus reducing the sensation of muscle pain after intense running. This is important for sport hunting dogs, right? As they need high endurance to run long distances for hunting and retrieving. This study showcases how behavioral traits in specific dog breeds are often genetically predisposed rather than learned through training. It also highlights the power of artificial selection on altering the gene pool across dog populations. In light of these findings, it seems essential to discuss how selective breeding directed changes in the genetics of dogs. Selective breeding is defined as the process where individuals are selected with the expectation of producing offspring with desirable traits. Down at the genetic level, this practice preserves specific DNA combinations of sires and dams, increasing the frequency of desired traits carried by popular breeding dogs within the breed's gene pool. So far, selective breeding of dogs has changed the physical attributes such as coat color, body sizes, skull shape, and also behavior and physiological traits. Technically speaking, we can create any breeds with certain functions tailored to human needs through breeding practices. Isn't that amazing? But there are hidden costs behind selective breeding. Kennel clubs provide breed standards that purebred dogs should conform to. In pursuing such standards, breeders often use breeding practices such as inbreeding to preserve the desired traits in offspring. However, as the two parents now share the same ancestry, there's an increased chance that the offspring will inherit identical alleles from both parents. Consequently, this could also increase the homozygosity of recessive deleterious mutations, leading to development of genetic diseases. It was found that mixed breed dogs are 1.6 times more likely to be carriers of recessive disease alleles, while purebred dogs are 2.7 times more likely to be homozygous recessive for the disease, further suggesting the danger of inbreeding. While inbreeding results in accumulation of deleterious recessive mutations in offspring, other aspects of selective breeding affect genetic diversity. In nature, a process called selective sweep occurs when new advantageous mutations increase in frequency, reducing or eliminating variation in neighboring loci due to linkage. In dogs, selective sweeps are expected to be found in regions close to the selected genes. Research has also found that sweep regions of selected traits are enriched with Mendelian disease genes. Well, this is concerning, because it means that intense selection for a desired trait could inadvertently raise the prevalence of breed-specific diseases. For example, golden retriever ichthyosis originally found in golden retrievers. As scientists have described, dog domestication is one of the longest ongoing experiments in human history. It really is impressive how humans have created so many diverse breeds. However, in order to produce the so-called purebred dogs, intensive selective breeding was used and have resulted in many breed-specific health issues. It is time now we make changes, such as avoiding inbreeding and using genetic scans to detect diseases before breeding.